what's going on, guys. I promise today's pregnancy diaries is 99% about packing my labor bag, what I actually think you would need versus what I think are, like, I don't know, based off of my personal experience, what is necessary versus what you don't really need. But we are at my 36-week pregnancy appointment as well, so I figured, well, you know, I've been updating you guys like 34 weeks. Now from here on out, my appointments are gonna become weekly, which I'm not happy about because I hate doctor. I hate going to doctor. I hate everything about it. Sorry, I'm having still heartburn. Not as bad, but it seems like over this past week, excuse me, it seemed like I got like a little bit of a break from heartburn for a couple of days where it wasn't so bad, and now it's just back full force. I'm also going into disgust. You're gonna see in an upcoming vlog, I actually thought I was going into labor like last week. Well, not an entire week ago, but yeah, I definitely thought I was going into labor. I was having really, really, really sharp pains underneath just my right rib, and excruciating back pain, like back pain that was shooting up my spine and like hurt my whole lower back. So I ended up calling the doctor just to be sure. And I just let them know what I was feeling and how I was feeling. And they said that there wasn't really any need for real concern, but just to like call back if I felt it was necessary to. But the thing is, like, I'm basing this labor off of Ella's labor, which I know I shouldn't, but like, that's the only thing that I, like, I've gone into labor before. So it's like, how did I feel when she was coming? A, she was a week late. So once I started getting crampy, I pretty much knew that she was on her way. With this one, and I was very short of breath with Ella. That was one of the major things that I noticed, is that every couple of steps or so, I would have to like pause and catch my breath, like literally catch my breath. With this one, with Hunter, it's been like I'm short of breath all the time, so it's hard to tell when I'm just like overworking myself versus like if labor is actually happening. I believe I've been experiencing Braxton Hicks, like even on my drive up here, my stomach was starting to get tight and then release, but it's not like you're supposed to kind of time your contractions, and I'm not really, I feel a little bit of tightening as I speak. But it's so hard to tell because they're not like crazy obvious. I don't know how to explain it, but I don't know. I'm a few minutes early, but I'm gonna go check in. You know, they'll check my weight and stuff. I think I'm getting actually a swabbing done today, which I'm not very I'm not really looking forward to, but I know that the swabbing is going to, like, they're testing for some sort of bacteria, I believe, for when the baby passes through, that they wouldn't like catch it or something like that. I don't remember exactly, but I'll let you guys know how awkward it was, because it's gonna be. And then hopefully from here on out, the appointments just get easier until it's actually time to go into labor. And my mom is leaving for vacation right now, so I really hope that Hunter can wait until she gets back on January 11th. I'm still not technically due for another like 3.5 weeks, but I don't know, this baby, I feel like he's trying, so we'll see. No, okay, so my appointment, great. It was pretty much just like a regular checkup. Obviously I mentioned the swabbing or whatever, but that was less invasive than when I went and had my cervix checked when I was having like issues. Still super uncomfortable, but it is what it is. My next appointment is next week, next Thursday at 1 o'clock, and they said from like here on out, it's pretty much just like routine appointments. I'm just backing up, hold that thought, cause I don't wanna hit anybody. So yeah, so there's no need like for concern or anything. I might stop and get some food real quick because I have a little bit of time before I have to pick up my daughter, but I don't know what the heck I want to eat yet. I just know I'm really hungry. But yeah, everything they said, if like I want to be checked out, that they can do a more like thorough exam, but they just took my blood pressure, my weight. My blood pressure has been fine this whole pregnancy. My weight, I'm at 140, it kept like bouncing back and forth between 148, 149. So I feel like I'm heavier this pregnancy. Mind you, again, I started at 114. I feel like I've gained so much weight this pregnancy, but it's all belly and my butt. My butt got gigantic. I don't know why. But yeah, no, everything's going good. Again, no reason for concern on his health. This guy doesn't know how to drive. Sorry. Yikes. I think I'm going to wait to film the second part of this video tomorrow morning, so you guys will be here and my daughter will be here as well. So, all right, we're good to go. We're almost over. This was week 36. Oh my God, this heartburn. I will see you guys first thing in the morning. Okay, guys, admittedly, it's been a couple of days since my appointment. I don't really feel that good. I don't know if I'm maybe getting like a sinus infection or something, but my sinus is all clogged. It hurts. I feel like congested, but there's not a whole lot coming out, and then my eyes are super watery. I don't really feel that hot, but I knew that this needed to get done before it was too late. So today we are packing my labor bag, as I mentioned in the first part of this video, but I did go out and stock up on some more baby items. So I figured I would show you guys this stuff first, because some of this stuff is gonna go into my labor bag. And then I found a list online of suggested items to bring in your labor bag. And this is my second time around, so, you know, I am going by memory, but I remember things that I really wanted at the hospital versus stuff that I packed that I didn't really need. As you can see behind me, I have quite the mess going on. Hopefully today I can get that a little organized and get my bag packed and ready to go. I'm just gonna start right away. This video honestly might end up being two parts by the time I edit it. I'm not sure. I'm like, I'm getting completely winded. This is why I've been having such a hard time posting. It's like, I am so physically exhausted that any chance that I get, I just need to like lie down. I'm literally weeks away from my due date, and all I did was get up and get a blanket, and I'm like, pooped. Anyways, I picked up some bottle cleaners. I am going to try to breastfeed. I've mentioned this all throughout my pregnancy diaries a couple times that I didn't have success producing with my first daughter. So I'm kind of mentally prepared to have to bottle feed again, which is fine. Like, I don't think there's anything wrong with that. I do want to attempt breastfeeding, but if it doesn't work out, I don't want to kick myself for it. But either way, down the line, I'm going to need some bottle cleaners. So I have one now, but I like to replace them after a while. So I got two new ones of those. These are they're from K Swift. I don't know. They're kind of like little sock shoes. These are really, really easy, especially with newborns. You just kind of slip them on. Now, my daughter was born in the summer, so it was a little bit of a different experience because she's a summer baby, he's a winter baby, and so my daughter kind of went without shoes for like the first 2 or 3 months because it was, you know, August and then September, and it got cold like closer to the end of September. So she didn't wear socks right away, or like any shoes. But with him, where it's winter time, although if you're going out with him, you don't want to like bundle them up and then put them in a car seat. Like, you just dress them pretty much normally, a little, you know, warm but not bundled, and then kind of like tuck them with a blanket and hat and stuff. So I figured these would be kind of perfect if I'm running out and I just need his little toes covered. So there's a set of 4 in here.
So they're really cute. Now, I went to Burlington, so everything was pretty inexpensive. I was able to get quite a lot and not break the bank or anything. So I might actually pack a couple of these because I think that's actually what I'm going to do. I'm going to put a couple of these aside because when we leave the hospital, you know, it is going to be cold and we're going to need something on his feet. Size 0 to 12 months, so he can wear these for up to a year. I'm going to grab two pair because they really are small and they don't take up a lot of space. So I'm going to grab the black pair and I will grab a white pair. And again, this is more like not in the hospital per se, but just like when we're leaving. So I have two different options to put on his feet. The other thing I got was these are swaddle me's. These are great. My white balance is a little crazy today. I never learned how to like swaddle a blanket properly. I was actually kind of annoyed with my first pregnancy because I asked the nurse, like, because she came in and swaddled my daughter, and I asked her, I said, can you please show me how to like get it tight? Like, I got the idea of it, but I could never get it like tight enough, and she would just kind of like blah break through them, and she like didn't take the time to explain it. She's like, oh yeah, you just do it like this, and then she did it fast again, and I'm like, okay, thanks. So these make it really easy, where they have, I think, just like Velcro or something. So I got a 3-pack of these, and again, he's really not gonna need this until we get back home, so that's something I'm gonna keep here. These I'm gonna pack with me. I can't remember, and this is kind of where I'm trying to pull out of my memory bank from the hospital, if they had like burp cloths. I'm assuming they do, but I don't think it's a bad idea to have some extra ones. So I picked up some four pack of flannel burp cloths. I'm probably gonna pick up more just because you have to burp them every time they feed, and babies eat quite a bit, and trust me, it gets messy really fast. I'm not gonna have time to keep up with laundry that quickly, so I recommend getting a couple packs of these. So I'm definitely gonna go and get some more. I feel like I want to make like a list or something somewhere so I remember what I still need, but these are going to be going in my bag. Next, I got these finger toothbrush things. I don't think I'm going to need this at the hospital. Usually when I was at the hospital with my daughter and we had no complications, I was there for like 2.5 days. Basically, she was born at 2 a.m, so we spent that whole first day there, a whole second day there, and then by the third day, I had my bag packed and my jacket on by like 2:00. I was so ready to go home. So like 2.5-3 days is what I'm expecting again. So I really don't think I'm gonna need like a baby toothbrush right away. I think this is for when they're a little bit old. Well, it says birthing up, so I don't know, but this is something that we can wait to do when we get home. These are some washcloths that I picked up as well, just for bathing time, and this was a pack of 12, I think. Oh yeah, 12. So just really, really handy to have, and these are going to be kept in my bathroom. I could also consider packing these if I wanted to instead of the little booties, but these are just like a pack of infant socks. They're 0 to 3 month socks, and again, it's just, he's a winter baby, so it's cold. My floors tend to stay kind of cold, so if he's, you know, if I have him on the floor at all, I want his little feetsies to be protected, so I just picked up a pack of those. I picked up a little pair of shoes for when he gets home. I can't help myself with kids' shoes. I don't know why. But these are really cute. They're just dark brown with red lace. I also got him a little pair. I know he already has a little pair of matching slippers, but I picked him up these little fox slippers as well. Honestly, I think these are closer to like 3 month socks. They're too big for a newborn, but I figured he would grow into them. I saw him, I just had to pick him up. I also picked up a comb and a brush set because I don't have mine for my daughters anymore. But they're just gentle brushes, just to brush his hair and stuff. These last couple of items that I picked up aren't for when he has to be a little bit older to use these. But I really like to have, like, on my car seat, I like to have some toys hanging. So I picked up this Hungry Caterpillar book, which he can pretty much use like once he can just start grabbing stuff, which is right away. But this will go on his car seat, and you can hear it's kind of like textured. And then I picked up a, it's an attachable ring rattle. So again, kind of like an accessory for his car seat. I picked up a pair of toy keys, and then I picked up, this one will be a little bit older, but it's a little cell phone, and it recommends for 3 months, so not right away, but I just kind of wanted to start building a collection of toys for him. So that is everything that I picked up. So now we're gonna start actually packing my labor bag, and this is like, I'm not like packing a bag and then gonna unpack it. Like, this is literally the bag that I'm gonna be using for the hospital. So I might add a couple more items up until the point of when I go. And then there's some items that I can't pack right away because I'm still using them. But my husband can, like, when he comes home, he can bring them to me, kind of thing. So I'm not too worried about it.